Jewish community leaders in Australia say the widespread condemnation of Israel's plans to build thousands of homes in East Jerusalem and the West Bank is drawing focus away from the peace process. The United States and the Australian government are among those that have criticised Israel's announcement. Plans were revealed a day after the United Nations voted in favour of granting Palestine non-member observer status. Dick Alder from the New South Wales Jewish Board of Deputies says the real concern is that the Palestinians aren't willing to re-enter peace talks.
The real issue is that the Palestinian president, Mr. Abbas, has refused to come to the peace table for 4 years now. Every Israeli prime minister, going back for the last half a dozen prime ministers, has committed himself to two-state solutions.
The Prime Minister, Julia Gillard, is expected to announce a plan to slow down the rise of electricity prices and save Australian families hundreds of dollars on their power bill. COAG will this week consider the plan, which will aim to reduce net worth gold plating and overinvestment in ties and wires by the state. If the plan's adopted by the states and territories, it will include reforms to set reliability standards, create two new consumer bodies and outline an agenda for flexible pricing. It's expected the plan could save between $2 and $3 billion of unnecessary investment in the country's electricity network, with the savings passed on to households. Policy, a man shot in Sydney's southwest is refusing to cooperate with investigators. Officers say a 23-year-old with a gunshot wound to his right leg went to Auburn Hospital last night and was later transferred to Westmead Hospital for treatment. Inspector Brad Thorne says the injured man has so far refused to tell police exactly how he was injured.
The male hasn't been very helpful in forwarding you with information on